My name is Echo, y'all. This what up? Welcome to my tech talk. I've been thinking the same. About to drop a little knowledge in this bitch for change until the head's not. We can run from the jump. Now everybody just shut the fuck up. Welcome to my tech talk. Y'all are sitting relaxed. So when I step up to the stage, I'll be spitting the facts until they... Okay, Cave Talk, and we are live.
And we're live.
I stole it from you again. And we got a special guest tonight.
You know what that sounds like?
My name is Victoria.
No, Tyler's, Victoria. Tyler's mac and cheese.
What does it sound like?
Oh my God, sloppy something.
No, it sounds like a dog licking a ball sack.
Okay, fine.
This is not a good idea. This is not what I should be doing. And like, God has a way of being like, you shouldn't be doing this. Since you're doing this though, that little Pomeranian right there, I was going to kick you in the nuts, but I'm going to let this little dog come and lick your balls. And... it's like sandpaper, bro. It's like...
oh, I was just thinking about afterward, the slobber, the cold.
There, like, there was no slobber. It was like a dry tongue. Like this dog had cotton mouth. And I was like, your dog's licking my balls.
What just happened?
That's not how it sounds. I know exactly how it sounds. And that's not
that's
the sound.
That's what good
pussy
sounds
good.
Okay, so today we got Victoria with us. Your IG handle is Lady Physique. Why is it Lady Physique? By the way,
just because I'm a lady for one, and I have an awesome physique.
Okay, so that's
how you came up with it.
Yeah, but that's like Devin physique.
Well, he's different.
Wait, okay, so Tyler, why is yours T-Sack 1000?
Okay. Yeah, why is that T-Sack?
That's so weird. I was like, all right, let's just do Tyler, and then my friend Nate Diesel. Which I missed that guy. He was on Shreds too. He was like, nah,
bro, you gotta have a cool one. You gotta be a douchebag.
I was like, yeah. How do you be a douchebag, bro? I don't even know how to get a girl. And he was like,
watch.
And he goes, T-Sack underscore 1000. I'm like, yeah, that's gay. And then
T-Sack 1000.
It was history.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's pretty fucking douchey.
And I actually became Lady Physique because I was a woman physique competitor, which I am as well. But I'm trying to bump down to figure. So
yes,
what am I supposed to do?
The fuck happened?
I'm not big enough. I'm too
what
petite.
What the fuck are you talking about? Look at this.
It's funny. We'll show some pictures of her. Like, I swear her arms are as big as mine. Like, when she's
I know. I'm not training arms anymore. It's a wrap. Everybody's like, oh, your arms are bigger than mine.
And they are,
dude,
though.
Every dude. I'm like, okay.
That's and I got some I got some thick-ass triceps, and I saw her hit, like, a bicep peak once. I was like, I'm never fucking flexing around her again.
Well, I don't train arms anymore.
That's why I'm staying far away over here.
How many years have you been a pro?
Since 2015.
So you've been pro for, how many, just math? Was that 7 years?
Yeah. Damn. We're like,
7 years. Yeah.
Pull out your toes, too.
Okay, so you've been pro for 7 years. How many pro shows have you done?
I haven't counted, actually.
So you've done.
I took a while off. I took 4 years off. So I did.
Was it four
the
years?
First, yeah.
I remember that.
The first 3 years, I killed it. I just placed every single time. And then, so that's the last one because I was done. That was a wrap. But then I came back and I was trying to do it again. And I just couldn't do it. I just moved to Las Vegas and trying to figure it out. So then I came back. During COVID, I thought, this can be over fast. I got it. So I had abs the whole time during COVID. Like, I was on my stair climber every morning at 5 a.m., killing it.
Was that when we worked together?
No, that was after, actually.
Huh. And we were trainers.
But I was the fluff cakes when we were together. That's for sure.
Whoa,
I was
we were not, together?
I said work together. When we worked together as self-made.
Yeah, no.
So you guys were at self-made. Okay.
Yeah, we worked over there. She trained her class.
So where? How did you guys meet? And then I'll tell my story about how I met Victoria because we met at different times.
It's kind of weird. You know how those nights you just like wake up and you're like, "Who the fuck is this?" I'm just kidding. Where did I meet you?
Well, I was following him because he's just shreds. Like, super coolest guy in shreds.
I was
ever.
Bound.
So I was already following him, and then I seen him at OVC when I just moved here.
It was like 2015.
I literally moved here, and I was like my first month in. I was like, "Ooh, I'm about it." I just got off stage, actually. I think a couple months before that. So when I got here, I was already shredded.
Yeah, you were jacked. I was in the gym with my buddy Val, and we were doing like back to back mountain dog split routine. Yeah. And I look over and I was like, fuck, this girl's jacked. I can't go stand by her. Like, I'm ripped. Well, I'm at my good.
He was shredded too.
You say that, and that was my whole thing too when I first met her. So go ahead. I want you to finish your story and I'll tell mine.
Yeah, I look over. I'm like, okay, hey, Val, can we go over there and do like triceps? Because we can't do back anymore. Like, we got to change the whole body part.
So I think, I don't know who DM'd you. I'm like, hey, was that you at the gym? Whatever, whatever. And we just became friends.
Yeah. We hung out at USA's or something.
Yeah, we went to the USA's when it was a national show.
So you met Val at the same time as me.
I met you first, but then Val showed up, and I was like, this guy's fucking funny as fuck.
Yeah.
And so our buddy Val and I became friends as well, and then your turn.
Well, I was way later. I was in 2015. So I met you at Dragons, yeah. And I think I was like 2 or 3 weeks out from doing my very first show.
So shredded. I was like, damn, he looks bomb.
Well, I didn't know that because it was like, you know, it was my first time, so I had no clue.
Yeah,
but you were training. But here's the thing is like, you were training with another guy who was the guy you were training with? He was a really big guy too.
John.
Oh, I remember that guy now.
Not Jonathan.
No.
Okay, John. No. Okay, we'll get that story.
Wait, how are we fucking talking?
I'm gonna tell you something right now. I never take Jonathan in public. Sorry, said it.
Okay, no, so
I seen that guy at the gym.
So she was training this guy. They were really big, but I assumed they were a couple.
He wasn't that big.
The guy she was training with? I mean, to me, he looked big. I mean,
well, back then, if you see him now,
no, this was 2020, dude. This 2021. This was just last year.
Yeah,
he was stout. Yeah,
yeah, he looked good. But together they looked good. They were training together. They looked good together.
We thought they were husband and wife, and we weren't.
Yeah, that's actually what I assumed. I assumed that they were married because I caught a married.
We had something, but it wasn't serious. That's it.
So
yeah, it was probably COVID.
It was COVID feelings. It was COVID feelings.
Pretty serious.
So I don't remember how we started talking, but we started talking. Like, friendly.
We became friends on Instagram.
Yeah, we became friends first. But was it on Instagram?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, I said something about, like, you and your husband. Yeah. And then you laughed at me, you're like, oh, it's not my husband. It was on one of your posts, I think.
He was testing the waters.
No, I wasn't testing the waters. I really thought it was.
He threw it.
He's like, oh, fuck, I forgot to fucking tie it off.
No, okay, so actually, I'll say this. Vic was actually post divorce was my very first date I ever went on, but I didn't realize it was a date.
We had
a conversation about this. Yeah, we hung out, but I thought it was just hanging out.
This is before you met me.
Yeah, it was before I met you.
PTU.
Yeah, yeah, it was before I met you. But I thought we were just
you're hanging. A new bitch. Sorry.
Yeah, I thought we were just hanging out, and then I think it was like months later. Victoria, like, she literally like, no, that was a fucking date, you moron. I was like, wait, what? I had no clue.
Yeah, you were just fresh out. You just wanted to go have a good time.
Oh,
you
took me to the cookie shop and a movie? That's not a date.
We did go see. We went to dinner and a movie. Right? No, we went cookies.
When you're married for that long,
I had no fucking clue, dude.
You don't know what's going on.
I didn't know how to date. I didn't know.
Like, I'm hanging out with a girl.
Yeah, that's literally
what's the borderline of a date and just hanging out.
Well, we didn't hook up. There was no anything.
I'm saying when you don't when you just get out of a divorce. Or marriage, you know, when you're going through a divorce, you don't know. You're like, it's blind like, to it almost.
You know like, what it's like? You know what? I'll tell you.
You know how it is.
I know how it is. We were just friends.
He probably didn't even feel like there was any attraction.
I didn't think she was attracted to me. I was like,
it's hard to tell at first.
What was going on with me in my head was that he just got out of this divorce, so I couldn't take him to like, okay, I'm interested in this guy. He needs to heal. So that was my theory. And so he did.
She was proper theory.
But then
he'll like as in like he'll like he's hurt or like he'll like a dog.
2 months later or a month later, I don't know what it was.
2 months later, I had a girlfriend.
And he had a girlfriend. I'm like, what the fuck? I thought you told me that you didn't want a girlfriend.
Hey, it was confused.
Well, it is what it is. You can't help what you like. And that's
no.
That's
but I'm trying to try. What was I trying to say? Oh, like when you're getting out of a marriage and you're like start dating again. It's kind of like the stepbrothers hug at the end of the movie when they're like trying to hug each other but they don't know how to hug each other.
Yeah,
that's what like dating is when you've been like with someone for 12 years and you have no fucking clue and like I you know you don't know how to make a move or do anything.
Yeah. No,
you're just talking and like realizing what I was talking about at the time was like so inappropriate probably.
Well, you're probably talking about your ex, huh?
I told you that day we hung out.
Yeah, she said don't ever talk about your ex again when you go on another date.
Yeah, whenever you go on a date. When you stop talking about your exes, then you'll actually land.
Then you're actually kind of ready to date.
Yeah.
But I told him that too. I was like, you talk about your ex 80% of the time. I mean, that's what it is.
Yeah, he loved that girl.
Yeah, I was in love. I was still in love. So that's why I didn't really see it as a date, though. I just saw us hanging out.
We're trying to get past something, too.
Yeah.
But that was so long ago. It was like a year and a half ago.
That's not very long. April. That was April of 21. So
it's not too long.
A while back. But I mean, it's not too long, but I know that he's healed. And
yeah, I'm pretty good now.
You're like not 100% healed, but you're baby healed.
Oh no, I'm good. I mean,
we have some faith.
Yeah. So, been a pro for about 7 years. What is some crazy stuff that you have happened to you, like online? Like, what are some of the craziest things? Because like, I got this kind of thing going right now where I've got my social media following kind of going up in numbers a lot every day, but it's all South America, and I'm seeing and hearing crazy shit. And now, you've got like 30,000 followers, and you probably have white noised a lot of the stuff. You probably don't pay attention to a lot of it, but you still get some crazy stuff, right?
Yeah, I ignore it or just.
Well, the thing is
you ignore it. You never like look and go, what the f-? Like.
So there's a peak when you're on Instagram and you gain followers. You go through that crazy time, crazy messages and stuff.
Uh huh.
But then there ends up running out of people.
But the thing is, what sucks now, I guess the new
she doesn't get hit up as much as she did.
You get to see everybody's content now. You get to see all their messages or replies. I'm like, oh my gosh, I don't want to see this stuff. It's annoying. Like, my people are my people. My followers are my followers. You know.
There's a way you can do like hide. You can do like hide messages where like if they're not following you, it goes to a hide message section, and then you can kind of delete them. Which you might want to look into that.
I don't really care.
Me,
if somebody's inappropriate, I just block them.
That's I had a huge following with the on first page. So now people, when they see me, they're like, "Oh, this fucking guy." Because I went through so much.
Yeah. Was there like a certain point though, like when your social media was building up, guys started sending you random stuff? Was there that first initial shock where you're like, "What the fuck? Why are they sending me this?"
Well, mostly on Facebook, if anything, but on social media, I don't. On
Facebook, is it usually Indian dudes?
Well, yeah.
All the messages I get all the messages I get on Instagram or on Facebook.
There's a lot of muscle fetish people, but I don't pay attention to that again.
Like, so do you get like a shitload of dick pics, or is there ball pics in there too?
No, I don't.
There's no way. You're a liar. I bet you if we went through her social media right now,
there's dick pics all over the place.
Hey, she probably doesn't even know about the hidden folder section, and there's probably like a shit ton in there. And we click on it, and it's probably just loaded with like baby dick pictures.
Doubt it.
Of like big old fat dudes.
Probably.
Doubt it. I don't know. But
do you ever get weird requests? Do you ever have like guys like tell me some
muscle fetish stuff? Like
throw it out there.
Can you pose for me? Can you be naked? Or can you? I'm like.
Can you fart in a can? But type of shit.
That's a no. That's a pass.
Has anyone ever asked you to do that?
Yeah, I mean all the time, but I just don't entertain it.
The dirty underwear, dirty sock thing is weird.
I got asked for my posing trunks by a couple. And it was so fucking weird because I had to see him at the gym all the time.
What's a couple going to do with him?
I was like, well, it was a dude and a wife, and the dude was trying to get me to sleep with his wife. And then
she probably has a smell fetish.
And then he messaged me after. I was like, no, dude, I don't want to fuck your wife. I was like, this is fucking weird. Like, no thanks. 2 weeks later, I get a message from them. They're like, hey, the posing trunks you wore at the show, are you open to selling them? Do you know? And I'm like,
are they going to sniff them? What's going on?
I was like, no, I'm not going to sell them. Like, I didn't say anything. I just, I blocked
maybe
the guy.
Maybe a Rocky role player.
I blocked the guy. I was like, how did this guy fucking find me on social media? It was weird.
He couldn't find the same underwear, man.
That was so weird.
They wanted a role play.
I don't really have a lot of weird stuff going on. Only just my ex stalker. That's it. That's so, the only weird motherfucker.
That's something else to get into. How many?
My fucking Instagram's lame. I feel like I'm 70.
I told you need to start over.
Nah, fuck that. I don't want no girls up in there.
No, it's
I like, already had done had that.
Yeah, you got your white teeth. You're good.
Yeah, what's up?
So how many fake accounts actually write you a daily that you notice?
I mean, I don't know. I don't keep track of that. I don't pay attention. But
do you ever have like a fake account write something shitty on your page?
1,000%. It's my ex.
It's your ex. Okay, so.
It's the only one that does that, though. The only one. I've had like a couple of gross, like, you know, the throw faces. You're so gross. Okay, well, you're probably gross, too. Let me see your picture. And they're private, or they have zero followers, or, you know what I mean? Like, it's something weird. Right. So, just, you know, whatevs. I don't care. I'm like,
fuck Instagram.
Sorry, yeah. Instagram.
That's why your page is inactive.
That does not define you. As
I did not say that Instagram.
When we talk about this one time, like Instagram followers, like Monopoly money, like who gives a fuck?
Yeah, no, yeah, it's just, even, yeah, it's not real. So, they get reality blurred with. There's a lot of people that have social media blurred with what reality is, because like it's really not real life. Like real life is like what you and I did last night when we went out cruising and having a good time. Yeah, and we did fun. A job and then we cruised back shut. Like that's real life, and people forget that.
My phone was dead the whole time. It was awesome.
But the whole time when people are doing that, they don't enjoy the moment. Yeah. You know.
So one time I was dating this girl named Christina. You know.
So you talked about that. No, Christina is C or K. Can't do it. Just kidding.
Sorry. I don't remember her name.
I did her twice. He just threw a name out there. He just made a name up.
Yeah.
Well, anyways, I love how you said the name and they both shook their head no at you. Like, no, you
my sisters. No, I did. She's like, a Mexican girl. She lived in
Mexico.
No, she lived in California. Remember, I lived out there for a little bit. Came back. I ended up dating her again later on. She kicked me out. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Or no, I left her. I don't remember. But anyways... So I'm sleeping and I wake up one night and she has like fucking 9,000 more followers. I'm like, yeah, that's not real. And she tried saying it was real and she's like, oh, I got fucking 30,000 followers.
Whoa, how did that happen?
So basically before she went to bed, she bought a bunch of followers. And by the end, when she woke up, it was at 9K more.
She bought followers.
I was like, you're lame.
Oh, so she bought 9,000 followers, but she's got like 20 likes on her pictures.
But you gotta know this.
Too. She's a pro bikini. She wins all the shows and.
But you gotta know this too. Say you have 3,000 followers and then you have 2,000 likes.
That's another. Well, she's buying likes too.
Oh my god, I can't.
Well, I don't know if that's true though, because like. I don't know.
No, the way you figure that out is you go to their following and every single one's fucking fake.
Oh, they're all fake.
See, I know all the little ins and outs on Instagram. Emoji, I just don't even talk about it.
They have the emoji with the water. Like,
yeah, no, that's... I get those sometimes.
And the eggplant and the water.
I'm like, what the fuck? Block.
The what?
So you know those
fake... I'm like so clueless.
The fake girls that they'll write notes and they'll have like sex links and stuff like that. Did you ever get those?
No.
Damn it.
Not sex links. I legit get like straight up like full on vagina shots and like
I'd be able to show you guys.
I was showing Erica right before this. I was like, Erica, I was like, is this real? Like, why would a woman just send this?
So this is what this looks like. Sorry, Erica, but this is what it looks like. It's a fake account, straight up.
They send stuff and then they send the phone number like with like you're on WhatsApp, right? Here's my number. And I'm like, yeah, let me just call you. You just blasted your vagina in my face.
It's kind of weird, huh?
It's to me, it's like. I guess there's a lot of guys that be like, I'm calling this girl. Like, but it's.
Remember that fake person they started hitting you up to? But actually got her. Oh, which one? There's a lot of them. This one, I went through a breakup and she hit me up and I thought it was a real girl.
And I thought it was?
No, I did. This before I met. Right before I met you. It was a catfish. It was a catfish, but it was acting as a really hot girl, which she probably looked just like her.
So they actually contacted. They were actually. They started following a bunch of our friends.
Yeah, red bikini.
Yeah. What?
She had like a red bikini on or whatever.
I'm trying to remember now, but yeah.
She's really cool. She was actually.
She
really,
actually.
I don't know.
She would actually give you her phone number to call her, but she would not.
No, she talked to me.
She talked to you, but she wouldn't FaceTime you.
No, I didn't.
We talked about that.
But there's pictures that were not the other person that was her.
That's easy to do, though.
Yeah, but it wasn't a girl.
Vic's like, I do this every weekend.
Yeah.
This was her profile ended up getting taken down.
Oh, I don't know what happened to the person, but the person, whoever it was nice, cool. Like, I had conversations.
I remember
it tricked me at first. You know, I didn't.
I remember the person tried reaching out to talk to me, and I said, yo, you're talking to my friend Tyler.
Yeah.
And, like, they're trying to have, like, a...
Because the page was pretty legit.
Yeah, they're trying to have an adult conversation.
It was...
Jonathan.
No,
it was a girl because she was like she like sent me a message.
She
like,
had a Instagram before that Instagram though.
Yeah, she said
it was really fucking really good.
It was crazy because she had like 70,000 followers.
No, this one had 900K.
Oh yeah, but wow. they were like real people following her. She put a lot of work into that just to get it ripped down. But she sent me a voice message and then she was like, here's my phone number, call me. And I never called her.
Yeah.
But I was like, man, this person really goes through it. But I said, I'm not going to call you. You're talking to my friend Tyler.
Yeah.
And then.
This is before I met my wife.
Yeah. Yep. So talking about fake accounts, we're going to kind of talk about something real quick because I kind of had an incident happen last week. Sorry, my voice is kind of gone. It kind of brought Vic and I kind of talking again a little bit. Like I reached out to her after it happened, but we had posted something about me not really dating here for the last year and me stating I didn't want to date in the States anymore. And I kind of went over my worst date ever. It wasn't you, don't worry.
I know.
Yeah, you were actually really good dates. Like, I always had really good conversations with you, and it was always really good. But we talk about that, and then this person starts writing me.